today, last class, whatever you have started, we have just give same board I have maintained. Only I make the S is a green symbol to look at that. Can only in a grammar there can only one and only start symbol, no other. You might ask question why, because this is the practice in all kind of grammar, not only context free grammar, only one start symbol, and the rules are numbered, and these are the AC start symbol here. The first of what you will check, which variables are nullable. Say here we found it, AC is nullable, true, and A is nullable. If it is nullable, do we know the first of any nullable variable and follow up that nullable variable intersection, that is how many terminals comes in the first of X and how many terminals follow, there should be no common, it should be shy intersection of this. So that is the case. We have found it is the set of terminals, and remember this all should be set of terminals, and epsilon can be there, dollar cannot be there in first, and dollar, that is end of input marker, can only come in the follow section of S, and any other variable it come, we'll see, but it definitely come after S. Okay, so dollar cannot come in the first, epsilon cannot go to the follow, and we check which are the variables can go to epsilon. We can see the rule, then by rule number 3, S go to epsilon, so it is true. Then first we have calculated and follow we have calculated, there is no common. So we know the for the LL1 grammar, the rule number 2, that is if non-terminal X can be derived epsilon, we will check whether first of X and follow of X should be psi. So it is satisfied. Now check for rule number 1, for each production A to sigma 1, that is a string, A to sigma 2 string, first of sigma I intersection of first of sigma j, for all inverted A means for all cases I not equal to j, so that we check it here for S. The first rule, the first of A, and for rule number 2, the first of B is B, and if S to epsilon, first of is epsilon, so for S is okay. We can check subsequently for all other rules, this first condition is valid. So it is now fit case for top-down parsing, but to design parser, you have to create the parsing table. The parsing table is this is the parsing and this is the parsing table. Remember, this algorithm here would change for top-down parsing, bottom-up parsing, and also subsequently table also change. This is LL1 parsing table that can be generated by programmer, but it can be generally it is done by a program. For bottom up parsing, your parsing table would change, and here also programming will change. So it's again a divide and conquer. Here you have the program, which is a table, lookup table basically. So here we'll use the lookup table. This is a parsing table, top down table, and we have the row is the variables, start with S, and all the terminals including epsilon, and we can find that, look at S and A, which rule can be there, we can fit all the rules, 7 rules there, and remember, no box, there should be one and only rule. If the box can vacant, that is okay, but there can be one and so that there will be no, so deterministic case. So if you can find here, and if you can find terminal there, there can be only one rule that can fire. That is the predictive parsing, deterministic predictive parsing, no backtracking, and it is a fit case for LL1. Let's try with this string, BCBA. So remember, whenever you top-down parsing, we fill the tags. This is a dollar is the end of stack marker. This dollar is different end of input marker, so they have different color. It is a black, it is a red, I mentioned. And in top-down parsing, you push first S, star symbol. We'll see in the bottom-up parsing, here in the end of top-down parsing, S will be taken out. And in bottom-up parsing, we'll start with a blank stack, and at end, S will come. So totally reverse. Here we start from the start symbol and try to trace from the left hand side LL and bottom of side is LR. We start from the right hand side, we reach S. So definitely that S will come at the last, here S comes at the beginning. And this is a string. Remember, this string, whole string, should not come to the stack. Remember, this is important point. So we should match with the top of the stack S, and here is the LL1, leftmost is small b, and parsing table you can find the rule number 2 is fit kind of. And so we take out S and the whole BAA comes here. Remember, B should be at the top because it's a left to right. B should be top. Now S is taken away. This is the step number 2. This S is taken away. The S is taken away. This whole rule number 2 comes in. But your B should be there. We should not take out. When we take out B or any terminals, whenever any terminals match, top of the stack terminal match, then we can take out. Otherwise, we will not. So here, now the top of the stack is B and your input is small b. What is the rule? This rule, rule number 2. Yes, so that you got it. Then, no, this b and small b, rule number 7. Mistaken. B to small b. So we replace this b with small b by rule number 7. Now, great, b and this b matches. So we take it out. Look at step number 4. I think it is visible. Step number 4 in the other board. Step number 4, because here b is taken away, and here also pointer moves this way. So right now we have CBA and B is taken away, so we have capital A, small a. Now you have to match capital A with C. Capital A with C, we match the rule number 4, capital A to small c A. So we take the capital A and put C A there in step 5 in the stack, and then we found that C and this C matches, taken away. So now the step 6, and now we see that the top of the stack capital A, yes, and your input is C is taken at B. Capital A and B, what's the rule? Capital A and B, rule number 5, A to small b A. So we take out capital A, put B A. Now good thing, B and this B matches. It's taken out. So see the step number 8. It is capital A, small a, and capital A. We can use the rule number 6, that is A to epsilon. You take the A without consuming anything from input. That is that, okay. So right now small a, and your end of your screen is also, your input is A, so both taken out. So right now this empty stack, and you have the input at the end. So this is the bottom top down parsing. So your stack start with S and should end with empty. This grammar is a famous grammar. This is your all arithmetic expression. It is called the expression grammar. I've repeatedly told you. So here, what is the first of this grammar? First, E plus E, and here it is, have E study and no T. So from there we derive this grammar, E to E plus T slash T. Why T? We want to prioritize the multiplication operation than plus. If we go for E plus E or for this E, and here also we don't need this rule, then the problem will be in any string. There will be no order. So we know very well that multiplication has overriding than plus. To make it happen, we add this rule. T is equal to T star F. So that we can, all multiplication should be done first, as in our arithmetic expression. So this is you call a very good expression grammar formality for any programming languages with infix notation. It is the infix, And why we go for this extra T? Because we want to prioritize. So this is a very efficient number. But this is not good for LL1 person. Why? Because the problem will be left recursion. See here, it left hand side E, also right hand side E. So here also T, here start with C. So both these rule violates top down parsing. Basic rule is first the grammar should be unambiguous. Grammar is unambiguous, no issue. But grammar contains the problem with the left recursion. Left recursion is absolutely no for top down parsing. So we have to convert it. But this is good for bottom up parsing. So later on, we'll do it for bottom up parsing. We'll see bottom up parsing, LR1 parsing can take more varieties of the grammar. Ultimately, all our programming language is run by bottom up parsing, LR1 parsing. But to understand bottom up parsing, we have to understand top down parsing, because which discovered earlier, and then we'll go for bottom up parsing. So our learning should be from the top down parsing. From top down parsing, we eliminate the undeterministic brute force techniques, because the problem will be back and forth. You have an inordinate amount of time complexity, space complexity. But if we maintain the two rules just we mentioned there, it's unambiguous grammar, and right hand side of all expression with the first all should be shy, and any variable goes to epsilon, then first and follow intersection will be shy. Then, and if we can a parsing table, and rows will be variables and columns will be terminals, every box should have only one rule or no rule. So that is a deterministic predictive parsing. No backtrack, and we can directly show you today and with example, with a simple stack, with a top down parsing, with a parsing table, we can parse any string. But this is, we cannot, the reason is, problem is, here the left recursion is not eliminated, so we have to remove by left recursion. How to remove? Let's see. So this is the, after, this is the original grammar. If you remove the left recursion, the grammar will look like this, and we have some extra E dash and T dash. So grammar will be, here we have how many rules? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 rules. Here we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Extra 2 rules for, we have to remove left recursion of E and left recursion of T. We have to incorporate another E dash and T dash. So we have extra rules. So this is now, you can see this is now, no left recursion is there. So this is good enough for top down parsing. So by the same rule, we have to calculate or fast and follow and arrange a parsing table and parse a sample string. Let's see. Next screen, yes, we can see it here. Yeah, you can see it here. This is the parsing table. For your reference, this is the original grammar, expression grammar. And this is, we remove the left recursion, we come here. And then we calculate the all first. Here you see, instead of S, the S is E, capital E. So grammar starts with capital E instead of S earlier. So we have first calculation here, first of E, definitely first of E will be first of T, and first of F. So we can come up here and then follow E, see follow of E, always a dollar, and also the end of in parenthesis. How it is coming? Follow, because if you see it here, see here in this rule, E right hand side is closing parenthesis. So it goes to follow of E. So follow of E consists of a dollar, it's the end of, and then is a this parenthesis. So first calculate the first of E will be first of T. First of T will be first of F. First of F will be forward exclamation, this opening brace. So first of E is opening brace, and by this rule, IND. So first of E is opening brace and IND. Now you calculate first step t dash. See, first step t dash is star. So first step is star, because t dash goes to epsilon, star, comma, or here the comma is not in epsilon. Then first step e dash is plus, first step e dash is plus, because e dash can go to epsilon, so epsilon. Now follow up e, star symbol here, follow up e. See, because start always you put dollar, and from here you can see after the closing parenthesis, dollar, comma, and follow of t. What should be the follow of t? The start of e dash. See here, follow of t, start of e dash, first of e dash is plus epsilon. Epsilon cannot be there, plus, and e dash can be end in, so dollar is there. So, and follow of t, follow of t will be first of e dash, plus should be there definitely, and because t dash can be in, so it's a dollar can be there. So we calculate first and follow, and any variable. So another, remember in my first exercise I wish to tell you that you may another table you should maintain by the same table whether the variable is nullable or not. Here they have not. I wish you always do the practice. I'll make a note there, I'll make a practice. So here, which variable can be nullable? E dash can be nullable, and T dash can be nullable. So we also see first of E dash plus E, and follow of E dash, first of E dash, follow of E dash, here the bit you have not done. But I will check it, you know, I've already checked it that there will be no common characters. So follow of e dash dollar. So first of e dash and follow of e dash, no common character. And then we go for which variable can goes to epsilon, t dash and e dash. E dash can goes to epsilon, so we have to check first of e dash and follow of e dash. First of e dash here plus, and follow of e dash is plus. First of e dash is plus, follow of e dash. What can be the follow of e dash? Follow of e dash, dollar definitely, because at the end, and epsilon, follow of e dash dollar definitely. Yes, so here also you see first of e dash plus, and follow doesn't contain plus. Are you sure? Please check this, because otherwise it is not possible. So there should be intersection. So next slide. Now we have this parsing table. This is the grammar. This is after left recursion. This is we calculate first and follow. But here I should, you definitely do for all variables which are go to epsilon. You have to say whether nullable or not nullable. If nullable, you check that first of that variable and follow up that variable intersection is shy. Now the same thing. This is one way, other way of saying that is taking a too much whiteboard. So parsing stack, dollar should be at the end, and you have loaded with E here. Here we have S, that is the star symbol, and this is the input string. And you have to predict from the parsing table. So because I can see int here and here e, so we go for e and int. So this is the rule, e to t e dash. So we take out e and put t e dash end of stack. But I have not consume anything from here, because if I have to consume int, this is a terminal, this is not a variable, this is a terminal int. Plus terminal is a plus terminal. I should match one int and this int, then I can take both. So here we have t, and you can see int. So what is t int here? Here int is here. So this is the rule, t f t dash. So that is f t dash comes, e dash is even there, but your input is still int plus e. Then you have to match. This is the top of the stack f. and this is INT. Now see here, AF, INT, then now it good, the int comes. So now finally you got int, you take out AF, put int, this int will be taken out, this will be taken out, so we'll have T dash, E dash dollar, and your int is taken out. Actually int in the string it is not taken out, only the pointer shifted. So, but from the stack it is taken out, from here it is taken out, and here input the pointer shifts. So right now we have a plus top of the, here the from the left hand side plus, and your top of stack is T dash. So you can see it's T dash and plus, there is only one rule, T dash go to epsilon. So you just taken out T dash by the epsilon, T dash to epsilon. So right now the stack is E dash and your input is plus int star, this is there. Okay, so now E dash to plus, you have to match. So E dash to plus this rule, E dash to plus T dash. So here is the plus T dash comes, the plus T dash, and you have a plus. Now good thing, plus and plus matches, you can take it away. So actually it is not taken away, the pointer goes to this plus can be taken away, so T dash dollar, and now int star, you have to match this T with int, int, go to table, T, int, you have T, ft dash. Now you put ft dash, you taken out T, put ft dash here, E dash, and you have int, that int remains. Now you have to match if and int. You can go there, see if and int, good thing. Now this rule comes, so int it match. So I can int, I have taken out if, int, and here int. So I can take both. So I have T dash, E dash dollar, and I have taken, actually I have not taken out, I have shifted, the plus is there, plus int dollar. Now we have T dash and plus. Parsing table T plus, so here T dash star F T dash. So put direct T dash star F T dash E dash, and here star is good thing, star and star matches. So you taken out of the stack F T dash E dash, and you start, you have go another pointer INT, then you have to take F and INT. Now go for F and INT, you have that rule. Another good thing, int comes. So you put int here, int here, so we are end up. So we taken out both. Now we have end of input, but your stack contains T dash and E dash, and you have very good rule. So T dash can go to epsilon, E dash can go to epsilon. So you both consume T dash and E dash. Ultimately your stack is empty, your input is empty, and success. So that is it. So we have done two examples, one with the whiteboard and another is expression grammar. So that's it. Any question?